everybody, Jessica O. Matthews here, founder and CEO of Uncharted Power. I used to say, self-proclaimed love child of Beyonce and Bill Nye the Science Guy, but now, post Black Panther, I'm gonna go ahead and say the original Shuri, right? And for those of you who haven't seen it, honestly, just get your life together. You have to see Black Panther. I think, like a lot of people, it's been amazing to see representation in a different way on the big screen, right? To feel like you can really connect and see yourself on the big screen just from seeing more diverse characters. But I think for me, the reason why Black Panther means so much, and particularly the character of Shuri, the younger sister of T'Challa, the Black Panther, because she's literally, I mean, gotta be honest, she's basically me. Like, so one, she's African, right? As I think almost all of you should know, and if you don't, you're about to know right now, I am a proud, proud dual citizen of Nigeria and the US. I am 100% Nigerian. I literally did my DNA test and thinking I would find something out really intense, and they're like, you are 99.7% West African. I'm blickety black, blacker than black, black, I'm blacker than black. She's also a younger sister. For those of you who don't know, I am one of four siblings, and the way things go in African families, here's how the importance kind of levels out. First, it's the first child. Like, it's almost like, oh God, look how God has given us this amazing daughter, or whether the first child. That's huge importance. I'm not the first child. Then it's the first son. Clearly, I'm not the first son. And then there's the baby. Guess what? I'm not even that. I'm the second child daughter. Better known as like the rando in the corner that has no actual official anything. Similar to how Shuri in the movie was like, you know, not called to be the Black Panther, to be the king. She's just kind of has to figure out what's her role and find her purpose in that kingdom, right? In that country. Even when she says she doesn't like to be comfortable, uncomfortable, you know, when she's at these special occasions. Again, why am I not wearing some random, tight, uncomfortable thing at any of the events you see me at? Because I don't want to. That's whack. That's stupid. Like, I will always be pretty much in a shirt and blazer because that's what I like. So yes, Shuri is me, and I could not believe that I saw that on screen. Like, I'm 30 years of life waiting to see me just there in my full completeness. And I think what really made it so exciting that it wasn't just the fact that she was African, the fact that she's a woman, the fact that she's strong and smart and the younger sister who still has the sass and does what she wants and loves kicks. It was that she was the lead technologist of the entire country of Wakanda. There was no person that she was kind of designing stuff and then looking up to. No, like, she built the Black Panther suit. She was the person who made everything work and get done. And that was so, so dope. And one thing that stuck with me, because they said it like five times in the movie, to the point where literally I was like, Ryan Coogler, like, I think we need to talk about royalties, I'm gonna be honest, that she kept on talking about kinetic energy. So you wanna talk about similarities. She literally said that the suit, the Black Panther suit, is powered by kinetic energy. And guess what I've been doing for the last 11 years of my life and getting 10 patents and patents pending on? Kinetic energy. I literally almost hopped out of the seat. It was amazing. And so anyway, saw that, got really hyped. I was like, wow, you know, this world, it's kind of cool to be in this superhero vibe. But I also think it's important to let everyone know that while that is a movie, while there's obviously a lot of fiction and narrative there, it's not just inspiration. The technology's real. In that I feel so represented by Shuri, I'm also letting you know that the technology she was talking about is possible, and in fact, that's what we've been doing at Uncharted Power, and a lot of that is what you've been seeing in our Power Lab videos. Kinetic energy is featured in the energy harnessing stroller, the energy harnessing football, the energy harnessing longboard. We've been developing energy harnessing cloths. Again, not to withstand bullets, because that felt a little extreme, but just mostly to charge your cell phone, but we could do that as well. And so I thought it would be cool, again, to really hammer in that this is real. We live in a world where if you want magic, get into science, that you could be a superhero and you could build a superhero suit. And I thought the best way to do that would be to explain as simply as I can, which I've been told sometimes can be hard, how I would build the Black Panther suit if I literally had a brother who was out, you know, just doing Black Panther stuff. And so, you know, I thought about it. And off the top of my head, it's like, you know, if you can't make it out of solar, again, you can't, it really does have to be kinetic energy, has to can withstand the impact. So what is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is the energy of motion. Energy is never created, nor is it destroyed. It's just transferred through different states. And one state is motion. When something's moving, that's energy. There's energy in that state. And the way that I would build that suit is by looking at how you would capture the kinetic energy of the motion from the bullets and the impact in a mechanical storage state, a state of almost potential energy, so you can amalgamate that or combine all of that power to be able to push it out when you want.
Hey, look at your suit. You've been taking bullets, charging it up with kinetic energy.
Easiest way I can think about it, let's take a rubber band, right? So let's imagine that each time the bullet or, you know, the kick or the punch is coming at Chala, that essentially his suit is capturing that kinetic energy, taking it in, taking it in, taking it in, taking it in, taking it in. It's here. This is full of potential energy of what could happen. It's storing all of that kinetic energy. And so it sits in this moment so that when it's ready. You can do that. And that's how he would blow all of those people away from him when he was ready. He would take those hits, take those hits, take those hits, and then push it out. Scaling that down, embedding that technology into the cloth, which is something that we do a lot with our different technologies for floor panels and whatnot, embedding that, shrinking it down, and basically what you have is a suit that's kind of like a rubber band slingshot. See, like, energy's all around us. Science is actually, again, just the study of life. And if you've ever shot a slingshot, or if you ever just kind of like pulled on a curtain and then did that big pull to release it back, you were engaging in the technology of Wakanda without vibranium, believe it or not. And so if you think that's kind of cool, you know, let us know. You want to learn more about how you could actually build this suit, let us know. Again, we want to build a community with you guys. If enough people say, Jessica, we want Uncharted Power to build the Black Panther suit, AKA, we want you to really own your full Shuri Princess of Wakanda nature, let us know. We are so down, and quite frankly, we're probably gonna build the suit anyway. So why not do it kind of in this big open way?
Woo! Let's go!
Wakanda forever.